glory belongs to you, Lord. We take time off of thanking you, Father, for what Jesus has done.
Hallelujah.
We can't do without you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
So we bless you on tonight. We bless you and we give all glory to you tonight. As Lord, as we surround ourselves with your word, we ask you, Father, for the revelation knowledge tonight. Hallelujah. Lord, speak to my vocal cords. Think to my mind that your people receive, thus says the Lord. Hallelujah. We trust your Holy Spirit, the one that you have sent to teach, to guide, and to lead. Have your way tonight. Bring healing, bring deliverance. Someone needs to hear. Someone need answers. Someone need direction, Lord. We trust you tonight. Do it tonight. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we give you all praise and all glory. In Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. The minister said we made it. Amen. We thank God for that. So we want to thank God and honor our chief apostle, our first lady, inviting us to share tonight. We want to congratulations for the 9 years. My mind just look up on the, I look up here and I just read for some of your attention to what you have right up here. You will see my glory, but you do not know. You don't know what you've been through. So you're celebrating tonight, but you don't know for the 9 years what you've been through. Amen. And sometimes I want to be like him. I want to, are you ready to pay the price? To see the price to pay for this thing. See, we think this Christianity is just a drop in the bucket, a microwave business. Amen. There's a price. Some of you want to be up there, but God won't be getting nobody up there. The way up with God is done. Sometimes the pressure, thinking, Lord, I want to give up. And that's where the will of God is, in the pressure. Hallelujah! It's in the pressure. So we just don't think that don't happen. Hallelujah. This is what Paul and these men went through. Amen. So we thank God for our apostle that made it this far. And we know with the help and the strength of God, the purpose of God will keep you. See, when you have purpose, the devil can do nothing to you.
Amen.
You have to remember that. When you have purpose, there is nothing the devil can do. That's why you always try. And that's, you got to understand that I'm here purpose. Say, somebody say purpose. There's nothing that the devil can do when you have purpose. It's something he will try, but it's all right. That's his job. But it's nothing he can do.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. Even the Bible says maybe sometime may weep and may glory for a night. So that means you're going to go through some stuff.
Amen.
And sometimes you might feel to weep, but it's all right. He said joy comes in the
Bible.
Don't worry about the weeping sometimes. Worry about sometimes feel to give, but you hear somebody say purpose. Devil can do nothing when you life for what? Purpose. Tonight we have a team. I know we have a team. Powerful team. And it seemed like I couldn't get the whole of the team. But the time God is not me, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
And Paul said I can do all things through what?
Right.
Through Christ. So, and the word Christ means what? The anointed one. So it's about the anointing. Amen.
Amen.
It's not about me, that's what that's what Paul was saying. I can do all things through the anointing.
Amen.
That's what he was saying.
Hallelujah.
God have mercy. It's the anointing. It's the anointing. So tonight I want to go on a different. So we got to bear with me. Amen. Hallelujah. In the book of Jeremiah, chapter 3, very familiar verse. Amen. And so when you let me tell you, when I preach, you gotta keep your Bible open. Amen? Because I like to go and see what the word says. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So I just let you all know. This is how I... Amen. In Jeremiah chapter 3 and verse 15, hear what it says. And it shall, and it will, and I will give you pastors according to my heart. Isn't that something? Hear what God is saying. That means everybody is not a pastor.
Right.
Some people want a pastor, but did God say, I give you that pastor?
Right.
This is why when we have a pastor, a man of God, we got to hold on and cherish that man of God.
Yes, sir.
That tells me that God have a heart.
That's right.
Everything begins with a heart. He said, I give you a pastor according to my what? Heart. So though God don't give any good to anybody. He gives somebody to say, give me the best. God only give the best. So if he give you a pastor after his heart, he give you the best. You could mess up, but he know. Amen? But you see here, I give you a pastor after my heart. And I love that. We're everybody called to preach, but everybody's not called where God put them as a pastor. That's something you gotta be called by God. A pastor.
Amen.
Not about glamour. No, but I want to look good and top you or be over people. Even God warns us and tells us, be careful. Don't be lord over my heritage. Even God says, be careful. So when God puts you as a pastor, the first thing you understand that this is his people. You are his, why the Bible says you are the under shepherd? Because Jesus is what? The chief shepherd. Hallelujah. We only know how we treat God's people.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
As a pastor, you can't be, hallelujah. Can't treat God's people anyhow.
Amen.
God bless you.
Hallelujah. But is a pastor have a duty? Amen. Hear what it says, according to my heart. God's, somebody say, God have a heart.
Heart.
We shall feed you with what?
Knowledge.
And understanding. So you have a responsibility. Not to just look over your soul, but to feed you. Hallelujah. And God expected him to feed you. Because it's after my heart.
Amen.
This is why it's imperative of a man of God or a pastor. You spend time with God to get the heartbeat of God. Well, hallelujah. To know about the people sometimes God show him. Amen.
Amen.
God will just preach anything. Amen. In spite of if you went to seminary or went to cemetery. But God, you got to hear from God. You know what the heartbeat of God for his people? When it comes to feeding his people. That they may have what?
Knowledge.
Why knowledge? The Bible said for the lack of knowledge, my people what? Lord have mercy. So God is saying, I'm giving you a responsibility to feed my people with what? Knowledge. Oh, don't preach your opinion. Too much politics. We don't even need them. Want to need, hallelujah. Feed my people with what? Knowledge. Lord. Isn't that something?
Yes.
Feed them any kind of thing. Feed them with what? Knowledge. If they don't have knowledge, then they will have destroyed because of the lack of what?
Amen.
Now the lack of prayer. Isn't that something? So we can be praying all night, all day, and we don't have knowledge, then the enemy can whip us because we have no what?
Knowledge.
Lord. Isn't that powerful? Somebody said, I need knowledge. Understanding. Have the knowledge, but you need all your understanding. And you know what I interpret that understanding as? Revelation.
Yeah.
Revelation. Things that uncover. Isn't that something? Because we have people full of information. Full of the knowledge, but they don't have no what? Understanding. Isn't that the Bible says? Get wisdom in all you get to get what? Understanding.
Yeah.
Oh. understanding, revelation. You understand? Hallelujah. We don't even understand. We have revelation of who we are in Christ.
Amen.
Revelation of new birth. Revelation of paying tithes. We don't have that revelation. Lord, let me leave that alone.
You preaching.
As a pastor, that's a pastor job. Amen.
You preaching.
But we gotta get the understanding. Where am I going? I don't know where I'm going. Holy Spirit, you take over. Amen. But I want to just talk a little bit about the heart. God looks at the heart. Because he talks about his heart. Amen. In the kingdom of God, it's a heart condition. It's about the heart. You can dress well. This is nice and God loves it. You look good. But you don't look at that. Don't look at your new suit and your new dress.
Come on.
He's looking at the heart. Yes. Isn't that something?
Amen.
The heart. Everything begins with the heart. Don't look at the outward. In the book of Genesis, let's go to the beginning. Always good to go back on God's beginning. Somebody said the beginning.
The beginning.
That's where God began. The beginning. Amen. You want to know the plan and purpose of God for man's life? Go to the Genesis chapter 1 and chapter 2.
Amen.
And there you get the whole plan and purpose of God for man's life.
Yes.
You want to read the whole Bible to know God's will or what God wants. Look in Genesis 1 and 2. Yes. And you see one of his. Amen. It's the plan.
Amen.
And he laid for man. Amen. But Genesis 5 tells us some 6. The 6th chapter of Genesis, verse 5. Hear what it says. Somebody say, have it. Amen. And God saw the wickedness of man was great in the earth. And that every imagination of what thoughts of his heart was only what? Evil continually. So you see where the evil begins? The heart. The heart. He saw the wickedness. And where he saw it? In the heart.
The heart.
Isn't that something? So man began, when Adam fell, man's wickedness was always in the heart, continually. But I thank God that he didn't leave us in a condition with a heart of stone. Some came here to take a heart. Jesus came to do what? To take over the heart of what? Stone and give us a heart of what? Flesh.
Amen.
God, I love it.
Hallelujah.
And he didn't leave us in this what? Dilemma.
Yes.
Amen? Amen. So we must know that God look at what? The heart.
Yes.
From the beginning, what man will do, continually wickedly in the heart. Amen? Amen. And the Bible says, look what God, look how far, look what God reached about man, the condition of man. Look what God condition, look what God said in verse 6. And he repented the Lord. Lord have mercy. That he had made man out of the earth and breathed him in his breath, in his hand. As somebody say, you know, God have a heart.
Yeah.
But God said, the way I wanted, what I planned for man, look what happened. I repented that I made man. Well, I thank God that he changed his mind. As we are here today.
Amen.
Isn't that something?
Yes.